Hi Faith Fam, back again with another video. I'm so excited to release this to you guys. What I'm about to give to y'all, what the Lord has just released me to release to you. And literally, this is so, the way this happened was just nuts, okay? I'm gonna pray and then I'm gonna get into it because I gotta, you know, obviously, you know, invite the Holy Spirit, the guest of honor into this so that he could do what he wants to do through this and in this video. Heavenly Father, I thank you so much for you. I thank our such a good Father. Breath and the air that we are breathing right now in our lungs. The fact that we are awake, the fact that we are alive, the fact that your sons and daughters who are even watching this, the fact that they're even able to watch it, Father, so thankful. You're such a good Father, and you are doing something in the earth, and you are doing something in your sons and daughters' lives, and you are doing something. You are cultivating things, Lord God. And I thank you for the shift that you are bringing into our lives. I thank you, Father God, that when we come to you and when we seek you, when we sit in your presence, that you're such a good Father, that you remind us every single moment that you can of all the good that you are doing, and that your promises are yea and amen, and that you are a good Father, that you fulfill your word and your word does not fall to the ground. So I pray in the name of Jesus, Lord, extraction, hindrance, and blockage of the enemy. Every spirit, Lord God, that has been whispering in your son or daughter's ear, that is watching this video, that has been trying to make them feel like what is the opposite of what you are about to have me release in this video, Father God, I pray that you would silence those voices, the voices around them, the negative voices around them, hallelujah. And that even right now as I speak, as I'm praying, Father God, that your Holy Spirit, your presence would be felt by them wherever they are. A wave of peace would run over them in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, that your presence would be felt. I pray that you would use me as you want to say, the way you want it to be said, and the way that you want it to be received. I pray that in the name of Jesus, Lord God, use me as your vessel. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. I'm so excited for this, you guys. I'm really excited because the way this happened was just so crazy. Like literally, I was literally finished posting up everything. So you've seen that I just posted a video a couple of minutes or hours ago, whatever time you're watching this video, you see that I have posted a video. The Lord really has me back in my mode of being productive. And I'm going to probably make another video as well. I feel led to make another video just about some of the warfare that I've been going through within the past couple of weeks. Severe warfare. But that's another video that I will make and I will post for sure, 100%. But what this video is like, let me just tell you what happened. So this morning, if some of you don't know, I will tell you that the Lord, sometimes he will drop words into my spirit. And usually when he just drops a word into my spirit, I know that that is because he wants me to get into his presence so that he can expound on what he wants to speak to me with regard to what he has given me. It's either usually a word or it's either a phrase. That's how I know that the Lord wants me to get my pen and start to write what he wants to deliver. And so you guys, what the Lord wanted me to deliver to you guys, first of all, there's two scriptures that he wanted me to make reference to for this video. Now, the main scripture for this video is Ephesians 3 verse 20. And I'm going to read it right now in the Amplified version. And it says, "Now to him who is able to carry out his purpose and do super abundantly," pay attention to that word super abundantly, "more than we dare to ask or think, infinite." Hallelujah. "Beyond our greatest prayers, hopes, or dreams." Hallelujah. "According to his power that is working within us." Hallelujah. "According to the power that works in us." Are you connected to the power? Are you connecting to the Lord God Almighty so that he's able to show you that power, show you what he wants you to do, and so that what he wants you to do, you can connect that to that power? Because through what you do, through your obedience to the Lord, through the works that you do, the Lord is going to cause a super abundance to flow to you because of what happens through you. Do you understand what I'm saying? So when I was walking outside, the Lord dropped this word prolific in my spirit. Oh my yana nama kasete shai. The Lord dropped the word prolific. So I'm just gonna read exactly what the Lord gave me. And the Lord just had me on a, you know me and the definitions. And you know when the Lord gives me a word, he always wants me to look up the definition. Because sometimes we know what a word is, you know, generally what it means. means, but to hear the exact definition of a word sometimes really helps to bring things into perspective, especially for me. The Lord was saying to me that it will be a prolific time in the earth. He said it's going to be like a divine proliferation. Divine proliferation is going to be what's going to be happening. And so he was having me look up the definition of prolific. Prolific means producing much fruit, hallelujah, or many offspring. Prolific means producing much fruit or many offspring. It means producing many works. And when I read this part of the definition, the Lord was saying his children are going to be, when they tap into him, hallelujah, when they tap into the Lord, when you tap into the Father and you allow the Father to activate the power that works, when you allow God to attach, when you attach yourself to him, because he is the power source. He's who you have to plug into in order to see things moving in your life. Hallelujah. I'm sorry I'm so loud, but I feel the presence of God on this one. This is a right now word he wanted somebody to hear. And so when you connect yourself to God, he is able to activate the power that worketh in you so that you are going to begin to produce works in his name. So for an example, we know the composer Mozart. We know composers and authors who create prolific works. Mozart created prolific works. His works were proliferated and he created so many. He created an abundance of works through his talent and his gifts that he was given. He produced many works. Until this day, we know about those works. We hear still to this day those works. That is what the first part of what the Lord was saying. He was saying, we are going to be as his children. This is for the body of Christ. And if you are not yet a part of the body of Christ, I suggest you do so, honey. I suggest you allow the Father to attach himself to your life. Because a lot of people are seeking because they feel empty. They feel like there is an emptiness. And they just can't get satisfaction in anything that they do. There's no satisfaction, even though you're in a specific sort of career or even whatever you're doing in your life to try to satisfy or fill an empty space and place, there's just no filling it. And you even are beginning to feel that. It's beginning to affect you so much that it's causing you to possibly go into a depression. It's causing you to possibly look at yourself and think that you're worthless and nothing. There's nothing to you. Do not let the enemy lie to you and tell you that there is nothing to you. There is something to you. When you learn your identity in God, and when God is able to really tell you, when you actually sit down, quiet yourself with the Father in the name of Jesus, and you allow him to speak to you, and you allow him to really begin to reveal to you your truth. I'm going to reiterate this again. The Lord always wants me to always remind you guys. This scripture, Colossians chapter 3, Romans chapter 8, the book of Colossians, the book of Romans, it literally explains to you your identity, your truth in God that you don't know, that maybe some of you don't know, or that the enemy has been trying to hide. Because of course the devil tries to hide who you are. You are a fearfully, beautifully, intricately, artistically made child of God that God had destined to fulfill a calling and a purpose. And you will do it when you connect yourself. This, what did the scripture say? He will do exceedingly abundantly above all you can ask or think. What you think and desire for your life, God has higher and more for you. Hallelujah. So the next part of this says, in regards to the definitions, the next thing that he was having me look at is proliferation. Because he said that there was divine proliferation that was going to happen in this time, this season. So the word proliferation means rapid increase, growth, multiplication, rapid increase, growth, and in somebody's life, God's bringing an increase of growth and multiplication, and the increase and the growth is going to be rapid. It's gonna happen quickly. God's doing things quickly in somebody's life who's watching this today. You are on the verge of God doing something in your life. And when that one thing happens, when the breakthrough happens, it's going to be proliferated. It's going to continue. There's going to be an increase in what God does for you in your life, the plans, the will of God over your life. Hallelujah. So something else the Lord was saying to me, there's going to be a spread of God's Spirit. The spread of God's Spirit will be more powerful. It will be even more stronger than the spread of the coronavirus. COVID-19 ain't got nothing on God. Ain't got nothing on the Holy Spirit. It ain't got nothing on Him, okay? Know that. Know that God is much more powerful than any coronavirus. Hallelujah. He's way more powerful than that. So what do we do in this time? During quarantine, we be wise and use wisdom and stay safe, stay healthy. And we spend time that we didn't have before with the Lord, which is something that I'm sure a lot of us have been hearing. Use this time wisely because God's about to do so much things in our life. But you have to have been spending your time with Him because you need to get the instruction and the wisdom from God to tell you about what's going to happen. You can't just be coming to clicking on a word all the time. You have to also be spending time with your Father because that's the way you get more insight into what is being spoken and more instruction through your process, the process where God is preparing you for whatever it is that He's preparing you for. So the Lord's saying there's going to be a spread of His Spirit that's going to spread. It's going to spread across the earth. This revival is coming. Hallelujah. Another meaning for it is present in large quantities, plentiful, abundant, bountiful, luxuriant, plentiful, abundant, proliferation. And then luxuriant means rich and profuse in growth. So what was happening was I was looking at the definitions, and then I was looking at the definitions. There were certain words that the Holy Spirit would point out to me. Say, go look at the definition of that word. So then I looked up the definition of that word because it says present in large quantities or plentiful and abundant or bountiful. That's another definition for a proliferation. Then another word that it gave similar was luxuriant. So I looked up the word luxuriant. He had me look at the word luxuriant. Luxuriant means rich and profuse in growth. Now, profuse, I looked at the definitions just now because I just felt led to do that, means exuberantly plentiful and abundant, or lavish and extravagant. So God is going to, because God is extravagant and He is our Father, He wants to do something extravagant and unprecedented in our lives. And that's what is about to happen. That's going to happen in our lives individually. That's going to happen in the body of Christ. That's going to happen in the earth. Another word similar to luxuriant that I found was super abundant. And that is in the scripture that the Lord, the version, specific version 2 that He asked me to read of Ephesians 3:20. Now to Him who is able to carry out His purpose and do super abundantly more that we dare ask or think. Super abundant, it means more than sufficient or over abundance. So this is what the Lord is saying. Now I'm going to read Luke chapter 12 because something else the Lord wanted me to make sure that you remember. And He always wants us to remember this. Don't focus on the things that you've prayed for already or on the things that God spoke over your life or on the things that you might feel that the Lord is speaking over you. When we pray to God, we don't have to keep praying to Him over and over again for the same thing. Did you know that? He hears you. He's heard you. What the Lord wants you to do, He wants you to seek Him first, right? Matthew 6:33. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. Everything else comes when you focus on the one who creates the blessing and everything God and God's will. When you focus on God and God's will, then everything else, you really don't have to worry about anything else. And so the Lord has had me in this scripture, and it was something that really genuinely spoke to me. And it's a scripture that I know, a scripture that I've heard before, but this is in the message version, which is, you know, is a version that the Lord has had me in for a while, quite some time now. I'm going to just read it, and then after I'll speak. It says, don't fuss about what's on the table at mealtimes or if the clothes in your closet are in fashion. There is far more to your inner life than the food you put in your stomach. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Your spiritual health, your spiritual digestion is more important. Hallelujah. Because we are a spirit. There is far more to your inner life than the food you put in your stomach, more to your outer appearance than the clothes you hang on your back. So there's more to life than your outer appearance, and there's more to life than what you put in your stomach. Because we know the Lord is calling us into a time of consecration for many. You know, he wants us to really, some of us even to turn down your plate, because what God is saying in this time is very important and vital, crucial that we hear from him clearly, and we're not distracted by the things of the world or the natural things. It says, look at the ravens, free and unfettered, not tied down to a job description, carefree in the care of God, and you count far more. Stop worrying. And I just pray against that spirit of doubt. I rebuke the spirit of doubt and the spirit of worry off of you right now in the name of Jesus. And it has to go and it has to leave, because God has not given us those spirits. He's given us a spirit of his power. Hallelujah. And those spirits must bow down to the power that is at work in you. Has anyone by fussing before the mirror ever gotten taller by so much as an inch? If fussing can't even do that, why fuss at all? Walk into the fields and look at the flowers. They don't fuss with their appearance, but have you ever seen color and design quite like it? The 10 best dressed men and women in the country look shabby alongside them. If God gives such attention to the flowers, most of them never even seen, don't you think he'll attend to you? Don't you think he'll attend to you, take pride in you, do his best for you? His son, his daughter. He made you and saw you. He made man and saw man. And when he was finished, he said that it was good. He created man for companionship with him, that he could have somebody that he could be in a relationship, a love relationship, an unconditional love relationship with. So you think God is not going to do his best to ensure that you're taken care of? What I'm trying to do here is get you to relax the scripture again. What I'm trying to do here is get you to relax, not be so preoccupied with getting, so you can respond then to God's giving. People who don't know God and the way he works fuss over these things. But you know both God and how he works. So steep yourself in God reality, God initiative, God provision. Focus on, again, what I was saying, the will of God, God reality, be in the spirit, God's initiative, what God's will is over your life so that you can fulfill it in the earth. Fulfill and spread the good news in the earth, and God's provisions, joy, happiness, peace. When we focus on God, we are in his perfect peace. Those are provisions that he provides for us that we can get through this life that we're in down here. When you're focused on those things, that scripture, you know, whatever things are lovely, whatever things are of God, whatever things are truth, I'll put that scripture below. But whatever those things are, set your mind on things above. When you'll find all your everyday human concerns will be met when you do this. Don't be afraid of missing out. And that's something that when I was reading this, I was like reminded of FOMO, you know, fear of missing out. The Lord was reminding me, like a lot of us have this fear of missing out. Oh my gosh, I'm not gonna get married. Oh my gosh, I'm not gonna get to fulfill this. Oh my gosh, I'm not gonna get to do this job. I'm not gonna get to do this career because I'm gonna miss out on it. I'm too old. I'm too this. I'm too that. You know, the Lord continuously. He really wants me to reiterate to somebody, let somebody know. I feel this in my spirit. It's not too late. And he keeps saying this over and over again because for some reason, I guess people really need to hear. It's not too late. It's not over. And it's not too late for you to do what the Lord has called you to do what it is that you know God has put in your spirit to do, to fulfill it. Don't let the devil put lies into your ear to have you feel like it's too late. And I rebuke in the name of Jesus the voice of the enemy in your mind that is telling you those lies. Don't be afraid of missing out. God has not given you the spirit of fear. You are my dearest friend. You are his dearest friends, his children, his loved ones. The Father wants to give you the very kingdom itself. Hallelujah. And so that's the word that the Lord wanted me to deliver to you. And I felt like that scripture, I felt he wanted me to read that scripture to close it out, just to wrap it and seal it up in his word. God is doing something prolific in this time, in our era. We are about to see God do his best work in this season, says the Lord. You're about to see something awesome. Hallelujah. Stay in his presence. Stay focused focused on God. Stay connected to him at the hip. Be joined at the hip with your father. Because listen, he's speaking in this time, you guys. If you go and you sit with him, allow him to speak to you. I'm telling you. I just went and literally within 10 minutes of me sitting with him, because I felt him pulling on my spirit to come sit with him. And within like 10, 15 minutes, he gave me all of this for you guys. I wasn't expecting to come on here again today to make a video again. But here you go, from God's heart to yours. I love you all. Don't forget, subscribe. If you ain't a part of the faith fam, what are you waiting for? Join us here. We are a family built on that scripture, Romans 8:28. All things work together. We are built on faith and through and by the strength of God and God's power. When we are weak in our faith, God is strong. So God can give you that extra measure of faith that you need if you ask him. And I just pray that he do so for you today. I love you guys so, so, so much. I'm so excited. And I want, when this begins to happen for you, please come back, testify to it in the comments. It's an encouragement. Your testimony can help somebody else and bless somebody else to keep pushing and pushing and pushing. I love you.